ओके रिकॉर्डिंग स्टार्टेड। सो नाउ सी, आई थिंक पीपीटी विजिबल टू ऑल ऑफ यू। ओके यस और
यस
नो?
सर, यस
विजिबल।
सो इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव स्टार्टेड द कैस्केडेड कंट्रोल, एंड इन द कैस्केडेड कंट्रोल एज यू कैन सी the cascade control is required where the more than one measurement is available, right? And there should be only one manipulation variable. So we can apply there, or we can employ the cascade control. So the best example of this cascade control system where we are going to employ the cascade control system, that is a CSTR in the chemical process control. So why we have chosen the cascade control? This has certain reason for the going to control the CSTR. So in the case of the CSTR, we are going to control the temperature inside the tank. Ultimate aim is to control the temperature of the tank, because due to the some exothermic reaction, okay, some exothermic reaction, some heat is going to dissipate, and our target is to control this temperature inside the tank, right? So in order to control the tank, in order to control the temperature of this tank, we will control the controlling parameters or the manipulated variable is this temperature. However, the control measurement is, or the controlling, we are going to control this temperature with the help of this coolant. Okay. So, and there is a one flow is there also. Okay. So we can control this with the help of the coolant, with the use of this cascade control. So this is the simplest, you can see, this is the simplest control system, or you can say the feedback control. You can say this is the simply feedback control. Okay. So in this picture, we have a set point. We are going to measure the temperature with the help of some sensor, and send with the temperature transmitter. Then we compare with the temperature controller. Some error will generated with the help of that error. And the temperature controller, the command will supply to the actuator, and that actuator will control the flow of that coolant. And ultimately, this coolant, the temperature of this coolant will decide the temperature inside the tank, right? So this is the simplest feedback mechanism. With the help of this, we are going to control, right? However, in this mechanism, what we are going to do, we are measuring this temperature, right, with the help of some sensor, and sending the signal with the help of the temperature transmitter, okay, and then compared with some set point, some error will generate it. Then again, the temperature control will send some value to the actuator, and that now we are just sending this, you know, the signal from controller to the next controller. Which controller? We are also going to measure the temperature of the coolant here. Okay, so that we can know, or we know the actual value, or the precise value of this, you know, the coolant also, and this temperature will be going to send to the next temperature controller, that is your the slave controller you have studied in the previous class, right? And this signal is compared going to send this temperature controller, and then in order to that, finally we are going to control the coolant flow of the coolant, right? And final temperature of this coolant will managed or controlled, and ultimately with the controlling of this temperature control, you can say the coolant temperature, ultimately we are measuring or going to control the, you know, the final control, final temperature of the tank. So our ultimate goal was to control the temperature of the tank. However, we are going to controlling with the help of the temperature by controlling the temperature of the jacket. Okay, so you can see here, this is the loop. This is the second example we have already studied in the previous class with the help of this hot jacket, is this one. Okay, so this was the simply, you can say, the difference of the loop, Okay, so this is the loop, you can say, oh my god. Okay, so this is simply feedback loop. However, this is a control, this is cascade control. This one is the cascade control loop. Okay, and this one is simply feedback control, nothing else, feedback control. Okay, so in this case, in the feedback control, you can see here, simply this is the controller that will send the signal to the, you know, the actuator or the control valve. However, this cattle is going to the temperature of this, our target is to control the temperature of this cattle with the help of the temperature of the jacket. We are just measuring the temperature of the cattle. We are not measuring the temperature of the jacket here in the feedback system, the simply feedback system. So we are just measuring the temperature of the cattle, just send to the set point, compare with the set point, some error will generate it, send to the controller, and then controller will generate the signal and send to the, you know, pneumatic signal that's sent to the you know, actual valve, actuator or the control valve, and in this way the control mechanism will work. However, in the cascade control, we are also measuring the temperature of the jacket here, as well as we are measuring the temperature of the cattle also. So cattle temperature is sending to the main set point. Okay, however, the jacket temperature is sending to the secondary controller, or this controller, this is the called the secondary loop. Okay, this is the called the secondary loop, and this controller is known as a slave controller, right? Slave controller, and this controller is known as the master controller. Okay, so this is the master controller, this one is the slave controller. Okay, now come to the next part, that is today we are going to study, that we are going to discuss, that is the mathematical analysis. Okay, how the cascade control, what is the transfer function, how the transfer function derived, okay, and how the stability of the cascade control is decided, right? We will discuss. So we will start our discussion with the cascade control. So we have seen what is the cascade control. Just cascade control is an alternative approach that can significantly improve the dynamic response to the disturbance by employing a secondary measurement and a secondary feedback controller. With the help of the secondary measurement and the secondary feedback controller, we are going to control the ultimate goal, okay, or we are going to improve the dynamic response of the system, right? Okay, so the outer loop of its controller are called the master loop and the master controller, whereas the inner loop and its controller is called the slave control loop or a slave controller. Okay, so you can see here, this one is the either it is called the secondary loop or the slave loop. This is also called a slave loop, you can say, or the secondary loop, or this one the primary loop, or you can say the master loop. This controller, you know, the primary controller or the master controller, however, this controller is known as the secondary controller or the slave controller. In the different book, both the nomenclature is given, right? Now come to the next. Let's say this is the picture, this is the diagram, this is a systematic, this is a block diagram for the cascade control system, in which you can see here the main process, ultimate process, the tank process, the temperature of the tank. Okay, so that is represented by the GP1. This process, the dynamics of this process, or you can say the gain of this process, is represented by the GP1. However, the temperature, what is GP2? Anyone can tell me what is GP2? What is GP2? Please.
So gain of the
sir, final process. Control element.
Final control element? No, GP2 is not final control element.
Sir, GP2 is coolant ka temperature, sir. Coolant
temperature. Yes, the dynamics of the coolant or the jacket. Yes, this is the dynamics of the jacket. Okay, or the coolant, right? this is the controller. We have not taken here the controller valve, okay, for the primary or for the secondary. It is, we have assumed that that is the linear, okay, linear valve is there, okay. So we have eliminated that part. So that GC2 is only here for the secondary loop, okay, and this is the primary controller, so this is the secondary controller. And GP2, as we have discussed, GP2 is the dynamics of for the jacket. However, this represents the dynamics of the main, the primary, you can say, the tank. Now, just to calculate the transfer function, that is our primary goal, Y1 upon YSP1. In order to that, just we are going to calculate or compute Y2. We have started our computation with the Y2. How the Y2 is calculated? You can see here, Y2 is nothing but the GC2, right, into GP2, GC2 into GP2 into whatever the error is coming, E2. So this is multiplied E2 into GP2 into GC2, yahan tak aagaya signal. And then, this is added with the D2, the disturbance, okay? So D2, the disturbance, okay. Now you can see here, the system have maybe the disturbance or not with the disturbance, okay? So yahan par humne disturbance, humne sara case le liya hai, D1 and D2, primary ke liye aur secondary dono ke liye. Maybe ho sakta hai ki disturbance na ho, without the disturbance, the system act kare, okay? So, yahan par humne kya kiya? GP2, GC2, or what is the E2? What is E2? What is the error? So, this error is calculated as a YSP2 minus of what? Y2. Can we write? What is D2? Sorry, what is E2? E2 is nothing but the set point of Y2 minus of Y2. Any doubt? Any doubt? No? So, YSP2 into GC2 into E2 plus D2. This is the, so we can rearrange or simplify simply in the terms of y2 ko idhar le jaya jaye, hai na, y2 term ko idhar le jaya jaye. We can solve this equation, so we can calculate simply y2. What is our y2? So y2, you can see here in the term of ysp2 and d2, okay? So it depends, y2 depends on the disturbance and the set point of the two second set point, or the, you can say, the jacket, the temperature of the jacket or the temperature of the coolant, depending on the temperature of the coolant, right? Now come to the next, that is your, you have to calculate, that is the wait a minute, just we can erase this one. Okay. Wait a minute. Okay, see. So now our target is to calculate, ultimate goal is to calculate the Y1. Ultimate goal is to calculate the Y1. Now tell you how the Y1 is going to calculate. So this Y1 is nothing but whatever the output is coming from Y2 at the Y2 is going to multiply it with the GP1. Whatever the signal is coming at this point, jo bhi aaya, yahan se jo bhi aaya, isko humne multiply kar diya GP2 ke GP1 ke saath, okay, aur ye aapka D1 ho gaya, okay, isko humne multiply kar liya, theek ho gaya. Ab is D1 ko humne add kar diya, add kar diya, right? Y1 is nothing but this signal, whatever this signal will come here, plus this. So yahan par kya aa raha hai? This into GP1, so it is represented like this one. Okay. Now, what is the, okay? Okay. So now calculate this one. So what is Y2? Y2 is nothing but this one. Just put it value here. Just go 12 put kar diya. Calculate kar liya. Now, this is the YSP2. Ye kya gaya? GP2. Into GC2 plus divided by 1 plus GP2 into GC2 into YSP2, this is the set point. See this one, and this one is the Y1 upon 1 plus GP2 into GC2 into D2 plus D1. Now, what is this YSP2? YSP2 kya hai? What is YSP2? This is YSP2. What is YSP2? YSP2 pe kya aa raha hai? So why SP2, the signal is coming E1 into GC1, right? Why SP2 is nothing but the E1 into GC1. Am I right?
GC1 into E1.
Yes, E1 into GC1 or GC1 into E1. Both are the same. So GC1 into E1. What is E1? What is E1? This is the error. E1 is nothing but the error. An error you can calculate with the help of YSP1 minus of what? Y1. Yes or no? So you can write here E1 equals nothing but the YSP1 minus of Y1. Okay. And ultimately you can arrange the Y1 and you can calculate what is the output, what is the ultimate output Y1. You can, in this picture, in this diagram, you can see here, with the help of that calculation, you can compute this value that is equal to the y1 equals to kya? Y1 equals to kya? Y1 equals to, this depends on the first parameter, set point 1, this one, set D2, okay, this one and D1. In most of the cases, these disturbances are absent. However, if this is present, then no problem. You can calculate with the help of this equation. So ultimately, Y1 is dependent on the YSP1. So you can calculate Y1 upon YSP1. That is nothing. Okay. So this is the transfer function. This one is the transfer function. However, if in the present of the disturbance, this one Y1, it depends on all the three parameters. Is it okay? Now, come to the next part. Next part is, in this, let's say there is no secondary controller present. Let's say secondary controller is absent. If the secondary loop is absent, in that case, what is the Y2? What is Y2? Y2 is nothing but the GP2, agar hai hi nahi hai. तो ये फीडबैक सिस्टम हुआ ही नहीं, राइट? दिस इज नॉट, देयर इज नो फीडबैक सिस्टम, इट मींस कंट्रोलर इज नॉट अवेलेबल, दिस इज नो फीडबैक सिस्टम. तो GP2 दैट डायरेक्टली मल्टीप्लाइड विद ISP2, YSP2. सो YSP2 इनटू G2, GP2, दिस वन इज द आउटपुट ऑफ द दिस सिस्टम. इन द केस ऑफ दिस फीडबैक इज नॉट अवेलेबल, वी आर सिंपली मेजरिंग विद द हेल्प ऑफ द प्राइमरी कंट्रोलर, और एक ही हमारे पास लूप है, दैट इज द प्राइमरी वाला, बड़ा वाला, ये वाला, ये यू कैन सी, ये है ही नहीं कुछ देर के लिए. तो इन द एब्सेंस ऑफ दैट, तब क्या होगा? तो हाउ द y1 इज गोइंग टू कैलकुलेट? सो y1 इज नथिंग बट दिस y2 इनटू gp1 प्लस d1. y1 इज इक्वल टू नथिंग बट द दिस प्रोसेस इनटू y2 प्लस d1. ओके, सो नाउ सिंपली दिस वन इज द कांसेप्ट. इन बेस्ड ऑन दिस यू कैन solve the tough and tough problem. Okay, so y1 is equals to gp1, what is y2? Okay, so you can calculate the value of y2 is here, just put this value. Here we have not taken the d2. You can, y2 is equals to, what is y2? Yt is gp2 into isp2 plus d2 plus d2. This d2 is also there. Okay, so here it is missing. So y1 equals to nothing but this value and y2 is equals to this value. Just put kar diya, solve kar liya. Okay. So this will come like this one. y1 equals to come this. This is the picture. y1 equals to, y1 will depends on the ultimately this one. So what are the difference in the presence of the controller? You can see here the ultimate transfer function is dependent on the GC2 term. However, in this term, GC2 is absent. Right? Now, come to the response part. Which one is the faster? Which one is the slower? And due to the introduction of, when we are going to introduce the slave controller, then the system becomes faster or slower? Or the system becomes accurate? Is the accuracy increasing or decreasing? What do you think about the response? Is the slave controller reduce the रिस्पॉन्स और इंक्रीज रिस्पॉन्स ऑफ सिस्टम,
इंक्रीज करेगा सर,
इंक्रीज करेगा. ओके लेट्स सी, लेट्स सी इन दिस केस, देन यू विल डिसाइड. मैथमेटिक्स क्या कहता है, लेट्स से दिस इज द ट्रांसफर फंक्शन व्हेन द सेकेंडरी लूप इज नॉट अवेलेबल और द स्लेव कंट्रोल इज नॉट अवेलेबल, तब क्या होगा? तो आप कह सकते हैं y2 upon y sp2, sorry, y2 upon y sp2, y2 upon y sp2, ये है y2 upon y sp2, क्या बन जाएगा जरा जी, y2 upon y sp2 सिंपली gp2 बनेगा, क्योंकि ये तो है ही नहीं, लूप है ही नहीं, सिंपल फीडबैक ये सिस्टम है, gp2 आया यहां से y sp2, एंड दिस इज द y2 प्लस d1. ओके सो हमने डिस्टर्बेंस भी नहीं लिया है, सिंपली हमने लिया है, तो यहां पर क्या हो जाएगा, y2 upon ysp2, y2 upon ysp2 is nothing but the gp2. Or let's say we have considered this is the first order system. Let's say gp2 is the first order, that's the cattle system, sorry, jacket system. Jacket system, as you know that, the dynamics of the this such type of system is the first order. We have considered that. Let's say this is the transfer function for the system is kp2 upon tau 2s plus 1. Tau s plus 1. As you know, this is nothing, this is a simple k upon tau s plus 1. Ye humne le liya. What is tau p2? Tau p2 is nothing but the time constant for the system. Now, so ye to ho gaya aap secondary system mein jab nahi hai, slave nahi hai. Now, in the presence of the secondary loop and the slave controller, अगर ऐसा होगा, दिस इज प्रेजेंट, द सेकेंडरी लूप इज प्रेजेंट एंड स्लेव कंट्रोलर बोथ आर द प्रेजेंट, लूप भी है और कंट्रोलर भी, तो क्या होगा, व्हाट इज वाई पी टू, वाई टू अपॉन वाई पी टू, वाई टू अपॉन वाई पी टू क्या बनेगा, यू कैन सी हियर, वाई टू अपॉन वाई पी टू, वाई टू अपॉन वाई पी टू क्या बनेगा, डिस्टर्बेंस लेट से डिस्टर्बेंस नॉट देयर, देन क्या होगा बताओ जरा, दिस इज द फीडबैक सिस्टम, नाउ एच क्या होगा, दिस gp2 प्लीज gp2 अपॉन वन प्लस gp2 यस और नो, सो सेम फंडामेंटल इज अप्लाइड हियर, सेम फंडामेंटल इज अप्लाइड हियर, यू कैन से दैट जी, यहां पर ट्रांस gp2 क्या है, gp2 के साथ एक और वैल्यू है, कौन सा, gc2, दिस इज द फॉरवर्ड गेन इज नथिंग बट द gp2 इनटू gc2, ओके वन प्लस डिवाइडेड बाई वन प्लस क्या gp2 इनटू gc2, दिस वन इज द ट्रांसफर फंक्शन, यस और नो, दिस वन इज द ट्रांसफर फंक्शन फॉर द व्हाट, फॉर द सेकेंडरी लूप, ओके नाउ gp2 की वैल्यू पुट कर दिया, एंड लेट से दिस द प्रोपोर्शनल कंट्रोलर, वी हैव, वी आर गोइंग टू यूज द प्रोपोर्शनल कंट्रोलर, हमने स्लैब कंट्रोलर में क्या यूज किया, सिंपली प्रोपोर्शनल कंट्रोलर, तो प्रोपोर्शनल कंट्रोलर के चलते दिस kc2 के चलते क्या हो रहा है, अब नाउ वी कैन सी हियर जस्ट टू सॉल्व दिस इक्वेशन, तो फाइनली द इक्वेशन विल कम kp2 * kc2 डिवाइडेड बाय tau tau p2 s + 1 विल कैंसिल ईच अदर राइट, एंड आफ्टर सॉल्विंग सो दिस विल गिव द kp2 * kc2 डिवाइडेड बाय tau p2 s + 1 * kp2 इतना, ओके So when you go to solve this one, when you take the value common, this equation will come. This is the gain. This is tau s, tau into s plus 1. So this is a tau. Okay, this is a tau in the presence of the loop, the presence of the loop. Now this is the time constant. This is the tau. This one is the tau. Now, please tell me. In this case, the tau is simply tau p2 when the secondary loop is not available or the controller is not available. You can see that simply this is the tau p2. However, when we are going to introduce the secondary controller or the slave controller, the proportional controller, we can use any controller and we can see the effect. Okay. So, in this case kp2 plus kc into kc2 tau p2 divided by 1 plus kp2 into kc2 now tell me the tell me the what is going to happen. Who is this? Who is this?
When Shilpa texts her, are you talking with her, Aditya? No, you are not in good terms and Japan. Okay, fine.
Are Palli? कौन सा तस्वीरों? न्यूटर भाई।
अनुवादर को सीरियस को जितने डाल दिए। बुद्धा बोलते हैं इनको सर मार्टर था ना।
पढ़ना तो है नहीं। फुल टाइम पास कर रहे हैं। ओके। सो टेल मी। टेल मी व्हाट हैपेंड?
टाइम कांस्टेंट कम हो गया तो सर रिस्पांस फास्ट हो जाएगा।
रिस्पांस फास्ट हुआ? अरे टाइम कांस्टेंट पहले से बढ़ा या घटा? पहले टाउ पी टू था, अब टाइम कांस्टेंट ड्यू टू द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ केसी टू कंट्रोलर केसी टू के आने से टाउ पी टू घटा ना? या सुनो,
यस सर,
ड्यू टू द केसी टू द टाइम कांस्टेंट इज डिक्रीजिंग एंड यू नो दैट व्हेन द टाइम कांस्टेंट इज डिक्रीजिंग देन रिस्पॉन्स विल डिक्रीज. ओके, so clearly there is a decrease in the time constant in the presence of the slave loop. This will guarantee that the time constant of the overall process decreases when a secondary loop introduced to the system, right? Eventually that decreases the overall response time. Response time will decreases, right? Response time will decreases, remember. Response time will decrease. ठीक है, अब हमें अब ऐसा तो आपने समझ लिया है कि जब तो what is the use for the cascade control? Why we are going to use the cascade control then when it will decreases the overall response time? Then why we are going to use? What is the advantage? Just tell me. What is the advantage? Have you any idea?
Sir, in this we can measure any disturbance in the system variables.
We will see. The accuracy is going to...
Sir, you know, accuracy bad jayegi,
going
sir.
To control the temperature of the jacket and the tank, you can say, in more precise way, in more, you know, accurate way. ठीक है? अच्छा, उसके लिए आपको कैसे करना है? इस बात को समझना है. यहां पे जो कंट्रोलर व्हाट एवर द कंट्रोलर इज गोइंग टू यूज, लेट्स से एक और क्वेश्चन है मेरा और क्वेश्चन आपको सही लगेगा. यहां पर आप कंट्रोलर यूज कर रहे हैं जीसी टू, यहां पर आप कंट्रोलर कर जीसी वन. तो जीसी वन और जीसी टू, अगर सपोज दैट कि जीसी वन जीसी टू जो कंट्रोलर है उसका रिस्पॉन्स स्लोअर है जीसी वन से. लेट से कंट्रोलर रिस्पॉन्स के टर्म में मैं बोल रहा हूं, इसका रिस्पॉन्स स्लोअर है जीसी वन से, यानी जीसी वन का रिस्पॉन्स फास्टर है. तो क्या ये कैस्केड कंट्रोल काम कर पाएगा? आप मेरा क्वेश्चन समझ रहे हैं? मैं कहना ये चाह रहा हूं कि कैस्केड कंट्रोल में इसका रिस्पॉन्स इसके रिस्पॉन्स है, यानी जीसी टू शुड बी द फास्टर देन जीसी वन. GC2 should be the response of GC2 should be faster than GC1. क्यों? ऐसा मैं क्यों कह रहा हूं? अगर GC2 का response faster नहीं होगा, let's say you are going to control the temperature of the tank. Ultimate goal is to going to control the temperature of the tank. और अगर jacket का temperature जब तक control नहीं हुआ, तब तक ये चल गया. आपको तो पहले किसका control temperature control करना पड़ेगा? With the help of cascade control, jacket का. यस और नो पहले आप जैकेट का कंट्रोल टेम्परेचर कंट्रोल करेंगे. बोलिए भाई.
यस सर.
यस सर.
जैकेट का सर एरर भी तो बढ़ जाएगा.
कोई बात, एरर कैसे बढ़ेगा इसके? फिर अल्टीमेटली यहां तो जा रहे हैं ना हम लोग, और एरर कैसे बढ़ेगा जब हमारा ये लूप है? तो इस लूप पे काम करेंगे तो एरर कैसे बढ़ेगा? अल्टीमेटली यहां पर हमारा एरर जनरेट हो रहा है ना. पहले हम इसको कंट्रोल कर रहे हैं, फिर इसको कंट्रोल कर रहे हैं फर्स्ट, और होना भी यही चाहिए. होना भी यही चाहिए कि पहले हम इसको इसको कंट्रोल करें, फिर इसको कंट्रोल करें. और जब इसको एरर कंट्रोल करेंगे तो इसका रिस्पॉन्स फास्टर होना चाहिए, इसका मतलब ये हुआ। कंक्लूजन में ये देना चाह रहा हूँ, कि द रिस्पॉन्स ऑफ दिस कंट्रोलर, द रिस्पॉन्स ऑफ दिस कंट्रोलर GC2 शुड बी फास्टर देन द GC1। सो जब भी आप डिजाइन करेंगे तो आपको याद ये रखना है कि इसका रिस्पॉन्स, जब भी आपको प्रोपोर्शनल PID, जब भी PID कंट्रोलर जब चूज करें तो आप याद रखें कि इस तरह से कंट्रोलर चूज करेंगे कि इसका रिस्पॉन्स फास्टर होना ही चाहिए एज कम्पेयर टू दिस वन।
हम तब का बोल रहे सर, जब GC1 बड़ा होगा GC2 से,
GC2 का रिस्पांस फास्टर होगा GC1 से।
हम वो बोले एरर बढ़ जाएगा जब GC1 बड़ा होगा GC2 से।
बिल्कुल 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 बिल्कुल। नाउ कम टू द नेक्स्ट पार्ट, दैट इज द स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ द कैस्केड कंट्रोलर। इन द टर्म ऑफ द स्टेबिलिटी कैस्केड कंट्रोलर, नाउ सी हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू कंट्रोल, हाउ वी चेक द स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ द सिस्टम। लेट्स से दिस इज द सिस्टम, this is the second order system we have considered, GP1. GP1 is the second order, let's say we have already considered, koi dikkat nahi isme, kuch bhi kar sakte hain. GP2 ko humne let's say humne liya hai first order system, simple 1 upon s plus 1 whole square le liya GP1 ko, aur GP2 ko 1 upon s plus, kuch bhi le sakte hain, this is a simple example. Now we are going to check in the absence of the secondary loop. So you know that the stability will calculate with the help of simple, if this is such type of equation is there, then we can calculate with the help of Rao-Thurwitz, or we can check that the stability with the help of Rao-Thurwitz. So we need, for the Rao-Thurwitz criteria, we have to first generate the polynomial equation with the help of the characteristic equation, that is the 1 plus GSHS equals to 0. So we have calculated this one, you can see with the help of the diagram, 1 plus GC1, GC2, GP2, okay. Oh, sorry, this is not GC2, GC2 is absent here. है ना? तो आप इसको first, second और क्या है? First process, second process और the primary controller, that is the GC1 we have taken. Okay. Just solve this equation. Okay. So, ये अब आपका equation आ गया. तो ये equation आ गया, तो आप इसको solve कर सकते हैं. तो ये आपका criteria दे देगा. Now come to the next part. When the secondary loop is introduced, then the characteristic equation is modified with the help of this equation. You can generate. आपके पास already equation है. D1, D2 absent है. आपने पहले से बना रखा है. ये देख लीजिए. आपने पहले से equation बना रखा है. This equation. और यही equation है ये. Secondary का यही equation है. ठीक है? ये वाला equation. 1 plus GP2. 1 plus GP2 into GC2, है ना? This one, this is the secondary, okay? तो आप इसको equate कर लिए characteristic equation को 0 से, you can see here, okay? Solve this equation, just modify or simplify, sorry, simplify this equation. After putting this value GP1, GP2, you can solve this one, okay? Or the KC2, KC1. यहां तक आपने कर लिया। अब हम राउ थ्रुवी लगाते हैं दोनों, पहले पे इक्वेशन पे ये आया, दूसरे इक्वेशन पे राउ प्रतिष्ठित इक्वेशन ही आया। और राउ थ्रुवी इक्वेशन लगाने का तरीका क्या है आपको पता है, पॉलीनोमियल इक्वेशन आपने एक्सपेंड किया, आप रो बनाएंगे या सुनो उसका आप कोफिशिएंट लिखेंगे, यू नो द हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू यूज द Rao-Thurwitz. Anyone who don't know, if अगर आप नहीं जानते तो हम लोग क्या करेंगे, next एक lecture में Rao-Thurwitz को discuss कर लेंगे. Okay? So क्या equation बना? The equation is nothing but the SQ. Okay? SQ plus, so you can write SQ, S square, S and S power 0. So the coefficient is 1, okay, and 3, then 3, then 1 plus KC1. Am I right? Yes or no? And then you can solve this equation. How you can calculate this coefficient? How you calculate this coefficient? 9 minus of this value divided by this value. Okay. So this will come in the picture. Okay. So for the stability of the system, the first column should be the positive, or the no sign should be changed. The no sign will change. This is positive, this is the positive, this is the positive. It means this should be the positive. When it is positive, it means 9 minus 1 plus KC1 divided by 3 is greater than 0. Okay, so it will provide this one. So KC1 is 8. In that case, in the first controller, in the absence of secondary loop, the criteria for the stability should be the gain should be greater than 8 in this case. Any doubt? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
बोलो भाई हाँ या ना तो बोलो समझ में आ रहा है कि नहीं आ रहा है
Yes, sir.
आधे लोगों को तो है ही नहीं आते अपना टाइम खराब हो ओके इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ द सेकेंडरी लूप व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन चेक आपके पास कैरेक्टरिस्टिक इक्वेशन ऑलरेडी है यू कैन सी हियर दिस इज द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक इक्वेशन And with the help of the characteristic equation, now we are going to compute the polynomial. Just compute the polynomial s plus 1 whole cube plus s plus 1 whole square. Isko solve kijiye. Solve karne ke baad ye aapka polynomial aa gaya. This is the polynomial. This one is the polynomial. Okay. So coefficient just to write 1 and then 3 plus 2, 1, then 3 plus 2, KC2. And then this value is here. Calculate this value, this multiplied, divided by this value. Ye aa gaya aapka. Isko solve kar lijiye. When you solve, then you got it. Aapko kya milega? Aapko milega ye ki what is the condition for the value of KC1. So KC1 aap calculate kar lijiye. KC1. Aapne KC2 ki value dekh rakha hai. तो जस्ट ये वैल्यू आ गया आपका सिंपलीफाई ये वैल्यू आ गया 8 प्लस केसी 2 प्लस ठीक है सो व्हेन यू प्रोवाइड द वैल्यू केसी 1 केसी 2 उसके हिसाब से वैल्यू पुट कर दीजिए तो यू कैन सी हियर दिस इज द रिस्पांस दिस वन इज द कैस्केड कंट्रोल दिस इज द कैस्केड रिस्पांस तो एक्यूरेसी देख लीजिए आपका बिल्कुल आपका सेट पॉइंट और ये आपका देखिए इसमें ओवरशूट है तो व्हिच हैज अ हायर ओवरशूट सिंपल फीडबैक सिस्टम और द cascade control
simple
feedback it is very clear, quite obvious that you can see here from this picture the cascade control will provide the more less error in this case and it is better going to control so this is the key point this is the conclusion of the primary or you can say the cascade controller the slave loop should be tuned before the master loop that I already told स्लेव लूप को पहले ट्यून करना पड़ेगा मास्टर लूप से क्योंकि स्लेव लूप इज मोर इसको पहले फास्टर होना चाहिए और पहले फास्टर होना चाहिए इसलिए पहले इसको ट्यून भी यही पहले करना पड़ेगा स्लेव कंट्रोलर को पहले ट्यून करेंगे मास्टर कंट्रोलर से याद रखना है आफ्टर द स्लेव लूप इज ट्यून एंड क्लोज द मास्टर लूप शुड बी डिजाइन बेस्ड ऑन द डायनेमिक्स पहले आपको इनर आपको पहले इसको देखना है स्लेव कंट्रोलर को और स्लेव लूप को सेकेंडरी लूप को उसका आप पहले सब कुछ देख लीजिए उसका ट्यूनिंग कर लीजिए कंट्रोलर का ट्यूनिंग करने के बाद ही आप प्राइमरी का देखेंगे पहले उसको एक्यूरेटली आपको फास्टर बना देना है किसी भी तरीके से देयर इज अ लिटिल और नो एडवांटेज टू यूजिंग कैस्केड कंट्रोल इफ द सेकेंडरी प्रोसेस इज नॉट सिग्निफिकेंटली फास्टर मैंने आपको बता दिया फिर से बोल रहा हूं देयर इज अ लिटिल और नो एडवांटेज कोई एडवांटेज नहीं होगा टू यूजिंग द कैस्केड कंट्रोल If the secondary process is not significantly faster than the primary process dynamics, in particular, if there's long dead time in the secondary process, अगर secondary loop में dead time है, इसका मतलब है क्या करेगा वो उसका response lower होगा, वो आपको primary से late है उसका response आएगा. It is unlikely that cascade controller will be better than the standard feedback controller. वैसे हालात में cascade controller काम नहीं करेगा. अगर dead time ज़्यादा किसके पास है secondary loop के पास है तो वैसे में cascade control काम नहीं करना क्योंकि secondary loop will not responding faster than the primary. In that case, that behaves as a simple feedback control system. The most common cascade control loop involves the flow controller. That is the temperature control, flow control. Example in the distribution column. You can we will see as the inner loop. This loop easily reject the disturbance in the चलो इसको छोड़ दिया जाए. तो आपको ये दो बिल्कुल ध्यान में रखना है. Number one और number two. Number one point और number two point. पहले ट्यून किसको करना है? सेकेंडरी लूप को. फास्टर कौन होना चाहिए? सेकेंडरी लूप. इस बात को ध्यान रखना. ओके सो दिस इज द ऑल अबाउट द कैस्केड कंट्रोलर. सो ट्राई टू सॉल्व द न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम ऑन द कैस्केड कंट्रोलर गिवन इन द कफनर एंड द सीबॉर्ग. ओके एंड इट्स ओके. इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट यू कैन आस्क. अदरवाइज वी विल एंड द सेशन. Now this